You're audible. Can you please turn on your camera? Yeah.
Yes.
You're visible, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
दरवाजे तक खुशियां पहुंचाते हैं और हम आपके निवेश किए हुए पैसों से इनकी आर्थिक सहायता करते हैं। तभी तो श्रीराम ट्रांसपोर्ट फाइनेंस कंपनी में निवेश किया आपका एक एक पैसा ना सिर्फ आपको मुनाफा दिलाता है बल्कि इन मेहनत कश योद्धाओं को एक उज्जवल भविष्य भी देता है।
जान पे अपनी खेलेगा, जिंदगी चलाएगा, सबका मौज उठाएगा, खुशियां तू पहुंचाएगा।
श्रीराम ट्रांसपोर्ट फाइनेंस कंपनी, विश्वास जीत का।
जिंदगी एक लंबा सफर है, इसमें कई मोड़ आएंगे, कभी अकेलापन और कड़ी धूप वाले दिन, तो कभी कड़कती बिजलियों वाली रातें आपकी परीक्षा लेते हैं, ताकि आप हर रुकावट का सामना करें हिम्मत के साथ। कभी निकल जाते हैं नए रास्ते, तो कभी करना पड़ता है इंतजार। दिन ढलता है पर आपका हौसला नहीं। याद रहे कि आप किसी भी परेशानी में अकेले नहीं हैं, हम आपके साथ हैं। श्रीराम ट्रांसपोर्ट फाइनेंस कंपनी का समस्त परिवार एकजुट है कि इन मुश्किल हालातों में भी हम सब चलते रहें, बढ़ते रहें।
हेलो,
In the beginning, when we started CSR, we wanted to make a difference in a customer's life or the
Hello,
so if you look at our business model itself, we are lending to a driver becoming
Hello, sir. This is your moderator. I'm audible to you, sir. Kishori, sir.
The person who not have a financial track record, we are welcoming and giving him a loan. CSR means beyond financing, beyond profit model. So
you are audible. Yes, sir. I can listen to you.
Being in the corporate world and being part of the community.
Okay, Mr. Moderator.
Yes, sir. I think Madam's speaker's output would have been muted. That would be the reason why she's not able to hear. Madam, hello. Please ring. Yeah.
For the last 40 years, Sriram engaging with the drivers, there has been a lot of worry. And we always felt that the drivers are being, treated as a stigma attached to a truck driver. So we felt that there are a lot more to be done as a responsibility of a corporate which has been doing business with the truck operator and making their, we have been growing with the truck operator. So we felt that there is time to give it back to them. So we have started three programs specifically, which
eventually will enhance and change the life cycle of the truck operator.
As far as education initiative of CSR is concerned, see, today many government schools, they don't offer free education in most of the cities. Now, most of the children of this customer segment, due to this affordability, they are not able to pursue their schoolings or then the college education as well. Our objective is to arrest this dropouts at the early stage. So we have instituted this scholarship initiative somewhere in 2013, and we have been consistently identifying the needy students right from 8th standard onwards, and we have been handholding them till they complete the school education.
I am a part of the CSR project that has been initiated by the STFC. Mainly for serving the trucker community people, and this project has been running for the past 2 years. We go to places where the trucker community is, trucker population is present, and we do services 6 days in a week. This project has been after for the past 2 years, I've been seeing this project has benefited a lot of people from the driver community, and because they are the people who don't get the most care from our health services from any part, because they are not present at one place. So they are continuously traveling. So Sriram has been very helpful. The STFC has been very helpful in treating, taking care of this trucker community people.
It's a Sridhar
Advisor. Transport Finance Company is doing corporate social responsibility. In this program, they selected the driving sector as a program. In this program, what they are doing is mainly they are sourcing the drivers, mainly the students from the below poverty level, and they give the 35 days of training. In training, they have 4 days of training, and finally, they will take the DL. After that, after DL taken, we are given the job opportunity, the livelihood, because they are from the below poverty. We have to give them some liability for the growth of the family members.
हमारे ट्रक ड्राइवर भाई को पैसा कम मिलता है ऐसी बात नहीं है, लेकिन एक उनको अच्छी सोच देना, अच्छा गाइडलाइन देना, ये बहुत जरूरी है। 30-35 हज़ार रुपया तो ड्राइवर कमा लेता है, क्लीनर को भी 10-12-15 हज़ार रुपया मिल जाता है। क्लीनर परमानेंट क्लीनर नहीं होता है, वो बाद में वो भी ड्राइवर बन जाता है, तो उसकी भी लाइफ बन जाती है। तो बहुत अच्छी सोच है श्रीराम गुप्त की, ये आगे बढ़े, हम भी साथ देते रहेंगे जरूर।
देयर इज अ ह्यूज ड्राइवर शॉर्टेज एंड बाय एड्रेसिंग दिस वी आर रियली हेल्पिंग द इकोनॉमी कंट्री टू एड्रेस द ड्राइवर शॉर्टेज एंड प्रोबब्ली इट हेल्प्स द ओवरऑल कम्युनिटी एज अ होल। वी वुड बी टेकिंग एवरी ईयर मोर स्टेप्स in enhancing in these three specialized activity our presence in the community.
Sir, Raju is there?
Sir?
Yes, sir. We'll reach out to you.
So, I'm Sridhar here. I'm just having some problem when I'm opening, getting the video. It says not readable. And HR or something like that is coming. In fact, when I opened the video, when we tried to do the sharing, so at that time, when I have COVID, it is coming now. I tried it for 3-4 times. So I don't know whether you can do anything to it.
We will try to reach out to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, Chairman sir. This is your moderator. Am I audible to you, sir?
Yes, I'm fine. Are you able to see me? Am I audible?
You're audible fine, sir. We are able to see you on the camera, sir.
freedom meeting is not over. Audible now?
The basic business of Shriram Group is
to provide loans and financial services
to small and
medium enterprises
and low-income families. This has served us well for over the last 3 decades and brought prosperity to nearly 100 customers that we have served so far, and also other stakeholders, employees, investors and lenders. I am personally very proud of STFC.
Thank you.
For single-minded focus on promoting financial inclusion of owner-operator and small road operators who are very often beyond the ambit of formal banking system.
Our the camera is view is perfect, sir. Thank
the
you.
Small business sector who are not served at all or not served very well by formal banking system. This small business sector, in fact, has proven to be one of the most dynamic and the fastest growing sector that contributes to almost 45% of GDP of India. I can confidently say that as a group, we have been most successful in helping our country grow by serving these customers. Thank you very much.
Forum completed, sir.
Bye.
Chairman, sir, you can proceed, sir. Thank you.
Good afternoon, members. I am S. Lakshmi Narayanan, Chairman of the Board of Directors of Shriram Transport Finance Company Limited. I am an independent director participating in this AGM from my office in New Delhi. On behalf of the board of directors. I take great pleasure in welcoming all of you to this extraordinary general meeting of the company. The requisite quorum for this EGM being present, I call the meeting to order. All directors of the company are present for this EGM. Independent directors, namely Madam Mrs. Kishore Udeshi, Mr. S. Sridhar, and Mr. Pradeep Kumar Panja, and non-independent directors, Mr. D.V. Ravi, Mr. Umesh Revankar, Mr. Michael Wiljohn. All the said directors were also present at the 42nd annual general meeting of the company held recently on Thursday, 24 June 2021, and had introduced themselves. They are all reputed and highly well-known personalities. So as such, their reintroduction at the AGM is not necessary. The joint statutory auditors, namely Mr. Sumant Sakar Dande, partner Hari Bhakti and Company, LLP, Chartered Accountants, and Mr. Pidush Gupta, partner Pidush Gupta and Company, Chartered Accountant, and Mr. Sriram, practicing company secretary, the secretarial auditor and scrutinizer for the purpose of the EGM, are also present. Mr. Parag Sharma, joint managing director and chief financial officer, and Mr. Vivek Achwal, the company secretary, as well as Mr. Sundar, joint managing director, are also present at the EGM. In view of the COVID-19 pandemic conditions and importance of social distancing norms, the company has arranged this extraordinary general meeting through video conferencing and other audiovisual means as permitted by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs and SEBI. You will recall that in order to further strengthen our company's capital base and balance sheet last year, on July 7, 2020, the company had offered to members for subscription 2,61,78,777 equity shares of face value of rupees 10 each, fully paid up at issue price of rupees 570 per share, including premium of rupees 560, aggregating to rupees 1,492.19 crores in the ratio of 3 fully paid up rights equity for every 26 equity shares held by eligible members on record date rights issue. The rights issue was oversubscribed by 1.65 times of the issue size. I thank you all for your kind support to the rights issue. In order to raise funds for faster growth of business, the company had made preferential allotment shares in the past to marquee institutional investors. Over the last 15 years, there has been substantial appreciation in the market price of the company's equity share. The closing market price of the fully paid up equity share of the company on National Stock Exchange of India on March 31st, 2005 was only rupees 55.35, which is increased to rupees 1422.30 on March 31st, 2021. The company has been consistently paying dividend to members for the past several financial years. Recently, our company issued equity shares of aggregate amount of approximately 2,000 crores to qualified institutional buyers under the QIP issue. This has resulted into dilution of shareholding of the promoters from 26.46% to 25.08%. The explanatory statement annexed to the notice dated June 12, 2021 of this extraordinary general meeting has set out the rationale and object of the proposed issue of shares and warrants on preferential basis to promoters for aggregate amount of approximately rupees 500 crores while the special resolution contained in the extraordinary general meeting notice. The proposed preferential issue of equity shares and warrants to promoters will further strengthen the company's capital base and balance sheet and help our company to augment the long-run resources for meeting funding requirements of our company's business activities, financing the future growth opportunities, general corporate purposes, effectively face the challenges of the uncertainties and disruptions being caused by COVID-19 pandemic, and improvement in our credit rating. It will also minimize the dilution impact of the recently closed QIP issue on the promoter shareholding, which will increase from 25.08% to 26.04%. I'm sure you will all support the special resolutions. I now request Mr. Vivek Ajwal, our company secretary, to take us through the general instructions pertaining to this extraordinary general meeting. Mr. Vivek Ajwal, please.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
I welcome you all to this EGM being held through video conferencing in accordance with the relaxations given by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs and SEBI in view of the COVID-19 pandemic conditions prevailing in the country. The facility for joining this meeting is made available to the members through video conferencing. All the members who have joined this meeting are by default placed on mute by the host to avoid any disturbance arising from the background noise and to ensure smooth and seamless conduct of this meeting. Once the name of the speaker shareholder is called out by the chairman, sir, the person will be unmuted by the host to enable him or her to speak. Before speaking, the member is requested to click on the video as well as audio icon appearing on the screen to switch it on. And if for some reason the member is not able to join through video mode, he or she can still speak using the audio mode. While speaking, the member is requested to use earphones so that they are clearly audible, and it would also minimize any noise in the background. They are also requested to ensure their Wi-Fi is not connected to any other devices, no other background applications are running, and proper light is available to have clarity in the video and audios. In case of connectivity problem at the speaker's end, the host will mute such speaker and the next speaker will be invited to speak. The speaker will be given chance to speak in the end after the resolution of the connectivity problem. Since this EGM is being held through video conferencing pursuant to the applicable circulars of Ministry of Corporate Affairs and SEBI, physical attendance of members has been dispensed with. Hence, the facility for appointment of proxies is not available for this EGM. A copy of the certificate from Messrs. Hari Bhakti and Company LLP, being the statutory auditors of the company, certifying that the preferential issue is being made in accordance with the requirements contained in the SEBI ICDI regulation, is available for inspection by the members. The notice dated June 12, 2021 of this EGM was sent to the members individually by email on June 13, 2021. On June 22, 2021, the company sent by email corrigendum to the notice of this EGM with regard to amendment of point number 11 and the last two paragraphs of page number 23 of the explanatory statement annexed to notice dated June 12, 2021 of this EGM. In order to widely disseminate the same, the company had posted the corrigendum on website of the company as well as websites of the stock exchanges. The company also published the said corrigendum in newspaper on June 23, 2021. With your permission, I am now taking the said notice dated June 12, 2021 of the EGM and the corrigendum dated June 22, 2021 already emailed to the members as read. As per the Companies Act 2013 and the rules made thereunder and SEBI LODR regulations, the company has provided facility of remote e-voting to the members to enable them to cast their vote electronically through the remote e-voting services provided by Messrs. K. Fin Technologies Private Limited on the special resolution set out in the notice of this EGM. The cutoff date for remote e-voting was Wednesday, June 30, 2021. The remote e-voting period commenced on Saturday, July 3, 2021 at 9 in the morning and ended on Tuesday, July 6, 2021 at 5 p.m. The e-voting module has been disabled by K FinTech for voting thereafter. The members who are present at this EGM through video conferencing facility but have not cast their vote on the special resolutions through remote e-voting and are otherwise not barred from doing so shall be eligible to vote through e-voting system during this EGM after the necessary announcement is made by Chairman Sir at the end of this meeting. The vote tab on your screen will be activated to enable you to cast your votes at end of this EGM. You can cast your vote by clicking on the vote tab. The members are given 15 minutes time for casting their votes. The results of voting will be declared today. The scrutinizer's report shall be placed on the company's website www.stfc.in of KFin at evotingkfin.com. The same will also be communicated to the National Stock Exchange of India Limited and BSE Limited. The Board of Directors has appointed Mr. Sriram, Practicing Company Secretary, membership number FCS 4862 Chennai, as scrutinizers to scrutinize the e-voting process in a fair and transparent manner. Approval of the members is sought for passing of the following special resolutions. Resolution number 1, to issue 17,36,100 equity shares of face value of rupees 10 each, fully paid up, to be allotted to Sriram Capital Limited, the promoter of the company, at rupees 1,440 per share, including premium of rupees 1,430 on preferential basis for aggregate amount of rupees 249,99,84,000. Special resolution number 2 is to issue and allot 17,36,100 warrants convertible into equity shares of face value of rupees 10 each, fully paid up, to Sriram Capital Limited, promoter of the company, on preferential basis at rupees 1440 per warrant on a preferential basis for aggregate amount of rupees 249,99,84,000. Please note that there will be no voting by show of hands. Since this EGM is being conducted through video conferencing, and since the remote e-voting process has already been completed yesterday, the proposing and seconding on the said two resolutions as set out in the notice of the EGM dated June 12, 2021 is not necessary. I now request Chairman Sir to commence this question and answer session. In case any speakers want to express their view, they can express their view about the company. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Vivek. The company has received requests from 5 members registering their names as speakers. I request all speakers to ask their queries and be brief. After all, speaker completes their queries, the same will be answered by my colleague and Vice Chairman and Managing Director, Mr. Umesh Revankar, and by Mr. Parag Sharma, Joint Managing Director and CFO. Speaker number 1 is Mr. Aspi Besania. Mr. Besania, please. Mr. Aspi Besania.
He is not
there,
sir, at this point.
He's not there?
Yes, sir.
I will now request speaker number two, Mr. J. Abhishek. He can now ask your questions. Mr. J. Abhishek.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me, sir? Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible.
I'll start my video also, sir. So my name is Abhishek, shareholder of the company. My DP ID IN301637 and client ID is 41359155. First of all, I congratulate the management on the eve of 42nd annual general body meeting. Sir, trust all is well with you and your family in this challenging situation. Our company deserves much more respect than the current market cap after completing more than a decade of successful operation, profitability, and dividend history, and becoming one of the strongest brands in our respective segment. Sir, I have already attended the meeting on 24th June to 2 p.m. I have already conveyed all my queries and I have also sent my queries through email also. And there is so much of corrigendum. In the email dated 20 June 2021, the corrigendum part, you have not given a detailed description, sir. It is actually confusing. Item number 3, ADM justification for modification order, which is the part we are modifying. And what is the prior error part? You have to show it separately. This is how the rectification has to be taken up. But in our case, we are just going on explaining what are the same situation. So we have to compare the previous report and this report and to find out that which is the part we are going to modify. Because in this particular corrigendum, which is being sent on 20 June, we are not able to understand it, which part of the resolution has been modified. So my questions are already sent through email and already the previous meeting, I have raised the query. There's no point in repeating the same queries again. I'm a well-wisher of the company, sir, and most of the shareholders, since we are not able to meet you personally for the past 2 years, they requested me to raise a query on the hospitality to be considered for shareholder by sending some gift coupons or something or the other instead of sweet boxes. So in the years to come, management may consider the same. And nothing much to ask. I wish the company and the board of directors a great success and prosperity in the coming future. Thank you for giving the opportunity, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Abhishek. Now I request Mr. P. Jaijan to speak and ask questions. Mr. P. Jaijan, please.
Sir, P. Jaijan is my father, sir. He has not joined the meeting. The same queries.
So then, can I now request Mr. P. Shyam Sundari?
Shyam Sundari is my mother, sir. No queries, same queries.
Okay. Then can I now request speaker number 5, Madam Rangalakshmi? All right. Can I now request speaker number 6, Mr. Ramesh Shankar Golla? Ramesh Shankar Golla. Okay, all registered have now asked their questions. I will now request our Vice Chairman and Managing Director, Mr. Umesh Ravankar, and Mr. Parag Sharma, Joint Managing Director and CFO, to answer the questions.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, shareholders. Your company, as you rightly put it, we have been offering our compliments when you attended our AGMs in person previously. We will discuss and with the board members' permission, we'll find out what best we can offer to our shareholders in the absence of sweet package. Apart from that, you have sent queries last time, detailed questions. For that, we will give a detailed reply. Bear with us for some more time. Maybe in a week's time, I'll reply to all the queries which you have given through questions in the last AGM. As far as the query gentleman is concerned, Vivek, you would like to answer that?
Yes, sir. I will answer, sir. The corrigendum is very clear. First, we had issued the notice of EGM. It is only point number 11 of the explanatory statement in which we have given more clarity with regard to the ultimate beneficial owner and other details. So, as Mr. Abhishek rightly pointed out, we had to know what was the previous paragraph and what is the new paragraph. So, both has been reproduced. I request Mr. Abhishek to refer to page number 23. Of this earlier notice, and new paragraph is reproduced in toto. And we also made that the other two paragraphs on the same page, these are the consequential changes in the paragraphs. So we have clearly explained what are the changes made in the express statement. There is no change in the resolution as such, but we have made it very clear as per the requirement of the stock exchange for listing of the shares. And in case Mr. Abhishek has further query on this, I'm ready to explain to him in detail if he has not understood of this. So from company's point of view, we have made it very clear, and it is only single corrigendum, and there is no change in the resolution as such. So everything is perfectly valid, legal. So I expect Mr. Abhishek Hughes, also being a lawyer, to please appreciate and understand it. And in case he needs any further question or clarification, I am ready to answer the same. Thank you, sir.
I thank all members for attending this extraordinary general meeting. I request you all to take care of yourself and members of your family, and also get yourself vaccinated, which is in your interest and in public interest. I also thank all my distinguished fellow directors for participating in this EGM. I now authorize the company secretary to conduct the voting procedures and conclude this EGM. The remote e-voting process was completed on 6th of July 2021. The members who did not cast their votes through remote e-voting process can now cast their votes through Insta poll facility. The Insta poll facility to cast the votes will be available for 15 more minutes. I have authorized the Vice Chairman and Managing Director, Mr. Revankar, to receive the scrutinizer's report on e-voting and announce the same. The results of e-voting and the scrutinizer's report will be posted on the website of this company, as well as on the websites of the stock exchanges on which the shares of the company are listed, and the website of KFin. With your consent, I and other board members would like to conclude this meeting and leave this meeting. Thank you.